Good Friday morning, everyone. I hope this has been a week that has lifted your spirits and encouraged you in your faith. It has for me. And I really needed it this week. There are some events, which I've shared actually this week, that kind of brought me down a little bit. Well, this last verse that we're going to look at today is one of the last things that are recorded, last words that are recorded of Jesus Christ himself. It's after he was raised. It's decades later. John is on the island of Patmos and he's given a vision and he sees the risen Lord. Read about it. You can read about it in Revelation chapter 1. And after he sees Jesus and Jesus speaks to him and gave him some words, and then I turned around to see the voice that was speaking to me. And when I turned, and you can read the whole description of him, but he basically turned and he saw Jesus Christ. And when he did, he not only went down, it says, verse 17, when I saw him, I fell at his feet as if I were dead. I think that's how, when we see Jesus clearly and in his glorious splendor, and we as how we view ourselves, then it's like, I know he says that, and he calls us his friends, but it's not like your friend next door. He is the Almighty God. He had called himself in verse 8 of Revelation 1, I am the Alpha and the Omega, who is and who was and who is to come, the Almighty. We're going to hear a song to close out this show and this week by the Gaither Vocal Band that really makes this point so clear. And that's why I wanted us to end with it. But Jesus kind of repeats himself now back to John. He says, I fell at his feet as though dead. And then he, Jesus, placed his right hand on me. Stop right there. If I were John, wow, Jesus placed his hand on me. And I think if you thought it through without even looking at the verse, I think you could guess some of the things that Jesus would say. And the very first thing he says is, do not be afraid. He is the awe, the majesty that he is. And he says, don't be afraid. Why? He says, I am the first and the last. I am the living one. I was dead, and behold, I am alive forever and forever. And I hold the keys of death and Hades. He's reassuring the Apostle John as he writes the book that we now call Revelation. And he's assuring him, don't worry about anything else. I am the first and the last. Everything has to do with me. And I hold the keys to everything in my hand. In my hand. Friends, that alone should give us the confidence, the faith, the encouragement, all we need forever and ever to behold him is to see life for what it is. He is everything in our lives. And we don't need, he says, do not be afraid. In other words, go forth with confidence. And the fact that Jesus has made sure that we got to read about this, and he put it in his book and saved it for 2,000 years for you and I to read today, tells me that same thing is true of us. Do not be afraid. Go forth with confidence. That's what we're going to do. Hey, I hope I see you at worship. Clubhouse 5 at 9 and 11 this coming Sunday. Love to worship with you. But let's worship right now as we close out this week together. God bless.
Out of heaven saying, behold, the tabernacle of God is with men. He shall dwell within them, they shall be his people, and Almighty God will be with them. Shall wipe away all tears from their eyes, and there shall be no more death, neither sorrow nor crying, and no more pain. The former things are all passed away. He that sat upon the throne said, behold, I make all things new. He said unto me, write these words, for they are faithful and true. And it is done. Lord of lords, he's everything. Messiah, Jehovah, the Prince of Peace is he. The Son of Man, seed of Abraham, second person in the Trinity. He is the